My dear students, engineering students, and field engineers, today let us discuss about drops in canal systems. A drop is nothing but a CC structure or masonry structure or RCC structure without shutters. Where we construct the drops? Generally we construct drops across the canal system below the sluice to heat up the water so as to send the water to the sluice for aqueduct. For example, I will show you a map here. See the picture here. This is the canal system. This is the probe here. Here a sluice is proposed to irrigate this aqueduct. This is the channel here. Here, this has three vents of any shape, maybe rectangle or trapezium or triangle. Here, see, to head up water here, the drop is constructed here. So that we will push up water through this channel for this aqueduct. This is one use. And secondly, where there is steep slope, nearby you have to construct drops. Maybe 2 drops, 3 drops, 5 drops, depending on the distance and slope. And where there is erosion of the system, there also you have to construct a drop, propose a drop. So, to save the canal bed from erosion, and where there is deep slope, or to push up water through the sluice for the aqueduct or any other purpose, we have to propose the drop. This is about drop. Generally, drop doesn't have any shutter or gate. This is without shutter. Openings may be of rectangle, trapezium or triangular. And here, the difference between this canal and channel, this is of small size. And this is of major size. Generally, from main canal, either branch canal or major is taken off. From major, minor is taken off. From minor, subminor, and from subminor, field channel is excavated, which is called as channel. And here, this is the longitudinal section showing bed level, FSL, TBL. Generally, we take levels at a distance of 25 meters, and for estimation purpose, for detailed estimate, we have to prepare the estimate at 25 meters intervals. And for line estimate, you may take levels at 100 meters also, no problem, for line estimate, for jungle clearance, for banging, or silt, for recording purpose, and for detailed estimate, take levels, 25 meter intervals here. BL means bed level, or CBL canal bed level. D is equal to FSD. FSD means full supply depth. FSL means full supply level. And here, this is FSL, full supply level. This is top bank level. Right side bank, left side bank. And without levels, it is impossible and difficult to excavate the canal. So, levels are very, very important to maintain its gradient, its fall, its slope. Without slope, what happens? The water flows in reverse direction. So, levels are very important. My dear friends, this is about drops. Do you have any doubt? In 3 cases, we have to provide drops. Where? To protect the canal's bed system, that is from erosion, and to push up water through the sluice. Generally its drop height 0.3, 0.4 times of the FSL, depends on the design. These are the uses of drops. Thank you.